What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Diz TV. Today, we are back with another Diz TV Weekly. We have some stuff to talk about, including a lot of new projects, but also some closures at Walt Disney World, as well as some shifting dates for the Marvel Cinematic Universe movies, and so much more. So let's dive right into it. Kicking off our video from the other side of the world, Hong Kong Disneyland has officially opened. It opened up on September 25th. Definitely good to see that another Disney park has reopened. Still, again, no word from Disneyland on when that will open, as I do believe that is the final Disney park to open up. Also, speaking of parks and resorts, Alani, Disney's Hawaii resort, is opening back up with limited reservations on November 1st. So from that point on, you can go to Alani. I don't know the specific restrictions that will be in place for the resort, but be sure I'll be here to cover it. And speaking again of resorts, Disney's Vero Beach, which if you don't know is on the coast of Florida, celebrates its 25th anniversary today, I do believe, September 29th. Happy birthday or happy anniversary to Disney's Vero Beach. Moving away from resorts over to the movie side of things, so let's start off with Avatar 2 has officially finished filming. Great to see that that movie is still underway as it's faced a lot of challenges. We'll see whenever we do end up getting a trailer, probably at some point next year. Speaking of next year, there will be no MCU movies for the first time since 2009. In 2020. Black Widow has moved to May 7th of next year. Again, it does impact some of the releases for next year. So Shang-Chi is going to release on July 9th of next year, and The Eternals will release on November 5th of next year. So we'll have three movies next year, but we still get some Marvel stuff with, of course, WandaVision coming towards the end of this year. And it is rumored that Soul, the Disney Pixar film, will most likely come to Disney Plus, premiering in a similar fashion to how they did Mulan. The Lion King live action will be getting a sequel, which Barry Jenkins will direct the sequel film. Now, it is unknown at the moment whether they are going with the actual sequel that was done a while back, I believe in the 90s, Lion King 2, Simba's Pride, which was very much a Romeo and Juliet styled film. We'll see if it does go in that direction, or it could go in a completely new direction, which I would actually prefer. And also in movie news, National Treasure 3 has officially been greenlit by Disney, which means we are getting this film. It's very, very exciting. I do like the National Treasure series. I think it is criminally underrated when it comes to franchises, specifically in the live action department. But very much looking forward to a third installment. Also, speaking of greenlit, Disney was testing out a watch party feature for Disney Plus, and it is official. We have a watch party feature that is available on Disney Plus right this moment. I just found out about it like a couple hours ago. It allows you to watch with up to 7 people, and any of them can pause, and there's like some emojis on the bottom where you're able to kind of comment on different things that happen throughout the film. And yes, it is, from what I have heard, keeping in time with it, so when your movie starts, everyone else's start. It is great to see that Disney Plus has added this feature, as it was very much needed early during the pandemic season, as most people were trying to find different ways to communicate and watch things together, but still glad to see that this feature is now available to the public. Apparently there is a Nick Fury show that is going to premiere on Disney Plus. Now, when it's set, I don't know. Most people's guesses, and my guess, is set after Far From Home. If you've seen the movie, you know the post-credit scene that he is involved in, and maybe setting up some new form of shield or maybe even sword from the comics. That would be really cool to see. Also, it is rumored that Brie Larson, Captain Marvel, will also appear in the series. So very much looking forward to it. And yes, of course, Samuel L. Jackson will star in the series. Let's move on, though, to some castings. as Yara Shahidi, I believe that's how you pronounce her name, is going to play Tinkerbell in the new Peter and Wendy film. She was on the show Black-ish. I'm very excited about this. I'm very curious to see how they're going to do this Peter and Wendy film. How close will it be to the actual animated film, or will this be a complete new direction? She will star alongside Alexander Mullany, who will be playing Peter Pan, and Ever Anderson playing Wendy, as well as possibly Jude Law, who is rumored to play Captain Hook. Alright, and what episode would be complete without some Walt Disney World news? A couple weeks ago, I mentioned that the Polynesian will be getting some new features and new redesigns, which is desperately needed. But we are seeing some concept art for the front entrance of the Polynesian Resort, and it looks fantastic. You can see some new to the monorail station that is on top of the resort, as well as, of course, the new front entrance look compared to this, which is the front entrance that it already has. I'm very much looking forward to seeing how this comes out to be. Very, very excited. It looks amazing. On a little bit of a bittersweet note, the Grand Floridian Society Orchestra will no longer be available as of early October. They will no longer be performing, not just at the Grand Floridian, but also at Walt Disney World in general. It's very sad to see. They were a prominent part of the Grand Floridian Resort for the past 32 years. Let's hope that Disney will implement some form of live entertainment and music back to the resort. It was announced just earlier today that 28,000 cast members will be let go due to the pandemic. And my thoughts and prayers are with each and every cast member. If you are watching this, that are dealing with this, I am truly sorry that you are going through this, and I hope you can find a job sooner rather than later. Florida, the government and the state of Florida, is entering phase 3 of their reopening plan after the pandemic season. And yes, while the pandemic is still going on, Phase 3 details that parks are allowed to be at full capacity once again, as well as restaurants and bars. Now, Disney has not stated their plans just yet on their Phase 3 ideas. I doubt we will see anything till early next year, if I had to put a little thought on it. I do think we will see bits and pieces of increase of capacity at some of the parks. Not all of them, as some of them is kind of harder to do. For example, Hollywood Studios is the smallest park at the Walt Disney World Resort, so it's kind of hard to have a more increased capacity because it's already super busy. Anyway, with that, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this weekly. And if you're new to the channel, again, welcome home. So glad to have you here. Be sure to subscribe down below and hit the bell to be notified for more videos on Disney, Pixar, Marvel, Star Wars, the parks, and so much more. I'll see you all in the next video. Have a magical day. Goodbye.